the IMO pod with three young kings, Sukali, DT and Uzi Bondis. In my opinion, we're the pod of the year. We mix the banter with the entertainment. Sukali, you know, be the girl them sugar. Don't talk DT, then they drive on.
Double juice loser, Uzi takes it too far.
Yeah.
You never know how far you can go if you don't try. We and them boys, we're not cohesive. Get
yo,
me? Come on.
But we're
yo.
Still here. Hey, Buck, what Buck, bro, make some noise.
Come on.
This is crazy, you
this
know.
This is mad. I can't believe we're here.
It's mad.
Hey, listen, yeah. You lot could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with us.
Come on.
And we appreciate that. In case you've been living under a rock, we are the In My Opinion podcast.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on, I am your boy, Mulinde the Fourth, a.k.a. Sukali, a.k.a. Salongo to be.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's your boy, DT, don't talk, just listen, a.k.a. designated driver.
It's your boy, Uzoma. Any other Uzoma is a counterfeit.
You can tell by their outfit.
You know?
Come on.
Yeah.
Listen. If you lot have been following our journey, God has blessed us this year.
Amen.
Come on.
We became from zero to hero.
Yes.
Yeah.
Listen, from no views to many views. So we're here to bless you lot tonight. We got some money to give away.
Yeah.
What are you trying to give away, Sukali?
Manange, I have money here.
Sukali, what are you trying to give away?
We are going through cost of living.
Yeah, cost of living.
So I have a lot of money here to give
Yo,
away.
Yo, yeah. Check it out. Yeah.
All right. Listen, you should have been given a raffle ticket with a QR code on it. Does everybody have a raffle ticket? Okay.
All right,
Make sure.
If you haven't got a raffle ticket, please put your hands up. Someone's going to come around and give you some raffles.
There's people without raffle tickets. All right, our sister, keep your hands up.
Just keep your hands up. Someone's going to come around and give you some raffle tickets.
Everyone got raffle tickets on this side?
All right, so with that QR code, to enter the raffle, you have to scan the QR code and follow us on Instagram, all right? At the end of our segment, we'll be picking out a random number to win £100. But not yet.
£100.
All right?
But yo, Sukali, check this out. I actually want to start giving away some money right now.
Come on.
Yeah?
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Is that
about?
Your feeling?
I'm in a giving mood.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying? So,
it's a season.
You know what? We're going to start this off with a segment called Don't Google It.
Come on.
So we're going to need two volunteers to come on stage with a chance to win £100.
Come on, £100.
How does that sound, guys?
But like a cost of living.
So we need two volunteers to come on stage to take part.
But like a quickly.
The raffle's won. The raffle's
won
of them.
We got one there. We need one
more. Can we give a round of applause?
Come right this way. Right that way. Thank you.
Samuel D. I think it's Samuel.
You wanna come on?
Samuel, where are you? Samuel is there. Samuel, come through.
Delay is dangerous. Please hurry up. Thank you.
Manang, who is calling us? Huh? Hey, hello. Is this your boyfriend?
No. Hello.
He's not your boyfriend. He's your friend with benefits.
No.
Okay. All right.
Come on, Mr. Samuel. Looking smooth. Come through.
Come on, Samuel.
Hey,
round of applause for Samuel, guys.
Come on, Samuel. Woo.
Come on, Samuel. Okay.
And what's your name?
DT.
Iman.
Iman. Make some noise for Iman.
Yay!
Well, I guess we all know your name is...
Samuel. Come
on. Make some noise for Samuel, please.
Come on.
Thank you.
All right, cool. You know what I'm going to do here? I'm going to do something a little fun. So, I'm going to pair each of you guys with a captain, with a sponsor. Do you understand?
Uh-huh.
So, who wants to be a man's sponsor?
I mean, I don't mind. I mean, if you ask it,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, all right, cool. So, Uzi, unfortunately, you got Samuel. You know what I'm saying?
Nice to meet you.
All right, cool.
We'll make this happen. We'll bring it home.
All right, cool. So, what I'm going to do is start asking you guys some questions. Yeah?
Okay. Yeah.
So, we've got team A and team B. You're going to get 6 questions, 2 questions each. Oh, 3 questions each, right?
Yep.
That's my maths. All right, cool. So what's going to happen if you don't get the questions right, it automatically goes over. If you're struggling, you can ask your captain, your sponsor, all right? Do we get the rules?
Yeah.
Cool. Now, each question is worth £20. Yeah? All right, cool. So Everyone's got the rules.
We got the rules.
Yeah.
If you don't get the questions right, I ain't giving you the money.
Simple.
You understand what I'm saying to you? I'm in a given mood, but I ain't trying to give it away
it's
for
Christmas.
Free. You
it's
get
Christmas.
What I'm saying? Soon. All right, cool. So
let's
we're gonna
go.
Start this now. Guys, don't help them, please. The name of the game is called Don't Google It.
So
please
don't
help
it.
Them. All right, cool. So we're ready now for the first questions. Let's go. What year? So who was team A? Do you remember your number, your letters? A and your B, guys. All right, cool. So this question is to team A. What year was the first very first model of the iPhone released? Let's go.
2008.
Woo! Wait, let's see. Did you get that? That's incorrect.
2008.
No, no. So you can't answer.
No.
He's answered it,
okay,
so you can't answer.
Apologies.
So this is going over.
Apologies.
I'm gonna transfer this over to team B. What are you lot saying? Give her your mic.
You
bro.
Can't help her yet. You can't help yet.
No, not yet. No, you need to go first. If you're struggling, he said 2008.
Oh, 2008.
No. He's speaking.
Wait,
watch him closely, please.
No, that's our sponsor.
No, it's not.
How about you say we can help after?
No, it's not. 2009. Oh, no, I was joking.
No. Look at this one. She said, I was joking. No, it don't work that way. No. Wait. So what we're going to do, I'm going to give you another chance. Ask your sponsor. Yeah?
What do you?
Quickly. Look, you got 3 seconds. 2, 1.
2005.
Look, she said, no. Incorrect. So guess what? I'll give you a chance to ask your sponsor. You got 3 seconds. Let's go.
I think, I don't think so. 2007. Is it?
I think I have a winner. £20. Bless her. Hey. Oh, yeah, put that money for your head, yo. Hey, your £20 up.
Yeah.
Hey.
I'm very happy.
Listen,
you.
How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel
lovely.
Amazing.
You see, we give our real money here.
Yeah.
Let them know.
Let me check.
All right, cool. Yeah. Next question. Sorry, my guy. Next question. All right, cool. So this goes to B now. They're starting first. I'm sorry. No, he can't. Guys, can you stop fighting, please? What's going on here? What do you mean? No. This is going to be the main guest. What year did In My Opinion podcast release their first podcast episode? You know like that. Can we go, please? Sharp. You got 3 seconds.
I can ask you, right?
No, you can't ask yet.
2019.
Woo! No. Hey.
So, right?
Yeah, you're close. So this is transferring over to Mr. A. Listen, she's winning £20. Come on, get your money up.
I'm going to go with the pandemic year because everyone was starting podcasts. So 2020.
This man is a calculator. He's a walking calculator.
Mathematics.
Jeez, mathematics. Your maths is mathing. Guess what? Bless him.
Boy maths.
Look at that. Yo, all right, cool. You guys
hold,
are even.
Hold it for me. Hold it.
You got 20.
Hold it
for me. He's got 20. Oh, you're keeping it for
hold
him.
It for me. Hold
do you trust this man?
Let him hold it for me.
He's an Igbo man. Do you
Igbo
trust
brother.
Him?
Don't worry.
Oh, okay, cool. All right, cool. Next question, please. This goes back to you, AEM. What was the most streamed Afrobeat song in 2020?
Wait, I think I know.
Hey, relax. Sit yourself down. Okay, let's hear it. Hey, move here, man.
Wait.
Don't look at him, bro.
I'm not sure what year it came out.
I would disqualify you.
I'm not sure what year it came out. But Burner Boy Last was popular. It's not.
No. Come on. Hey. Go on.
That song. I just want weed. Not weed. Weed and Hennessy. That thing. But what is it called? I got the song, song? But what's that song called?
Weed and NSC.
No, what is it? That's in English.
Weed no, and NSC.
What's the song? What's the song? No, you know.
Hey, hey. Oh, okay, no, 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 no,
no, no, no, no.
Name
no.
one song then.
No, I know what the song is.
Three.
Oh my gosh, it's
two,
out of my head.
One.
Last. Hey, no,
he
that's
said the same thing.
No.
No, last time.
It's,
okay,
it's wait, a weed and wait,
wait, wait, wait. Chat to your sponsor.
What's it
I'm going to come back
weed
over here. Talk to your sponsor. What's the answer?
He's even more lost than me.
We're
can you give
trouble.
Us a clue? Give us a clue.
How can I give you a clue? It's £20, real money. Pounds. Great British pounds. Move out of here, man.
Listen. I didn't say that. He was talking.
I'll give you 5 seconds. Four.
No,
three.
Wizkid. Wizkid.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Which one?
Essence.
I can't look it up.
Essence.
DJ, run that shit.
I try to teach you, but I need some lessons. I need to give it all.
That's it. Yes, sir. Listen. Hey, this guy, you're not here to play, oh. You're not here to play. He's not here to play. Hey, guys, don't fight. You're a sponsor. Don't fight. All right, cool. Listen, you have a chance to balance. You have a challenge, chance. Eh? Let's go.
No, I'm going to trust you more. Thank you.
All right. Who did Forbes name the youngest self-made billionaire in 2019? Billionaire. Not millionaire. Billionaire.
Kylie Jenner.
Give her the £20. Let's go. They came here to play. Cost of living is really hitting. Eh? Hey. All right, cool. Let's go. Guys, listen here. Yeah, this is the last question. You've won 40. You two, you've won 40. Wow. We only have 100. It is unfortunate. But you go first, yeah? Oh, no, no. You know what? I want to be fair. Can we flip a coin for the last question? I need a coin. All right, cool. Rock, paper, scissors. Yeah? For who gets to go first? Let's go. Rock, paper, scissors for who gets to go first. Let's go. No, best out of one. Whoever gets this one.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Rock, paper, scissors. Come on now. Okay. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
He won. Yeah.
No,
he grabbed you.
Young girl.
You lose.
Let's relax.
We go first.
You don't know the thing. Relax. No, you won. Yeah. You done your thing. You done your thing, my bro. Don't worry. You done your thing.
Give me the mic.
All right, cool.
In the end.
Hey, I like this guy, you know. I like this guy.
I know the
answer.
All
right, cool. So he gets, that don't mean he's gonna win.
No, yeah.
All hopes are not lost.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
I may not know it.
Which movie franchise character holds family as the most important thing in the world?
Wait, you said character, not movie.
Yes, which movie franchise character?
But not the actor. The character.
All these questions, all these legal actions you're trying to take against me. Hey, no. You cannot. Oh. He's you first. You can't ask him.
I don't know his name in the movie, you know.
Five.
Oh, no. They said
four. Three. Two.
Fast and Furious.
One. Oh, boy. That's over to you. Let's go. Let's go.
Big Mama.
Big Mama Shekini. Big Mama Shekini. What did Big Mama do? This one, your light has not gone out yet. Hey, listen. It's back to you now. Talk to your sponsor.
He don't
Oh, you don't want your sponsor.
No, he don't. Wait.
He fired his sponsor.
No, wait.
How did you fire your sponsor?
So. Wait, do you lot know Vin Diesel's name in the movie?
I've got one.
His name is.
See this guy. 5, 4, 3.
Dominic.
Huh?
Dominic.
Dominic what?
Dominic.
2, 1.
Guys, help me cheat, quick.
Hey, this guy. You must really need this thing. But I'm sorry. Yes, let's go.
Black Panther.
Hey, that was me. It's on.
You know what I'm gonna do? No.
No, I'm not having it.
No, leave. Hey, put your hands down, man.
It's all right.
When we said come on stage, did you want to come on stage?
Yeah. Ask him again. Yeah.
Guess what? I'm giving it to you, bro. I'm gonna give it to you. Because guess what? It's Fast and Furious. Dominic Toretto. Dominic Toretto, you won it, bro. You got it. Black. I'm going to give it to you. I don't know where Black Panther came
from.
Guess what? Take your thing, my boy. I don't know where Black Panther came from.
Why did they say Black Panther?
Yeah. But listen, though. No. Wait, guys. That's the end of this game.
What's your name?
Samuel.
Guys.
Samuel.
Guys, can we say...
Make some noise for Samuel, please.
For Samuel, please. Samuel. Thank you, my boy. We won. We took that
Iman.
Home.
Can you make some noise for Iman, please, for trying?
Come on.
Thank you so much. Big man.
Wow.
Appreciate that, man. Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Well done, Samuel.
Yo.
Hey, man, them.
That was intense.
That was very intense. Who is Dominic?
What Dominic Toretto? What do you mean?
Nah.
Vin Diesel.
I don't know.
What do you mean? Vin Diesel. That brother there with the... it's all about family and that.
Banang.
And always doing film tricks. He's always driving over the cliff.
For no reason. That movie.
Yeah, you know that guy now.
Ladies.
Yeah.
You people always say, Nigerian men, Ugandan men, we are stingy. We just gave out £100.
Look at that.
Huh?
We the support of a Nigerian man. Don't miss that part.
Hey, listen, thank you to the people that took part with the game.
Thank you.
Make sure you guys, you got 26 minutes. To scan the QR code, follow us to win £100. Right about now, we're about to get into the dilemma section.
They haven't given you.
Follow.
Madam,
follow.
Where's madam? Somebody, put your hand up.
If you ain't
guys,
got the
put
barcode.
Your hand up. Yeah, they're coming around. Yeah,
one barcode, please.
It's
finished.
Sorry. He don't go.
Pele.
He don't sorry. Finish. Sorry, yo.
Okay.
Let's get the chairs here, man.
Come on. Let's go.
All right, so if you've been watching In My Opinion podcast, people call us the Dilemma Kings because we're really good at answering dilemmas.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got a very special dilemma for you. So we need silence.
Silence, please.
People that are over-talking.
Yes.
And then we're going to pass a mic around in a crowd to get your opinions. All right? Now, I normally read these dilemmas in a Ugandan accent. Shout out if you know about Uganda, if you're Ugandan in the building. Come on, shout out, Ugandans.
We're not going to do that one here. Shout out all my Nigerian people in the house, please. Come on,
let's go. Yeah. In fact, we can't do that. Shout out all the Africans in the house.
Come on.
We can't forget all our other brothers.
We're all one.
We can't forget all our other brothers.
My Caribbean people in the house.
Yeah.
Why for that? I feel like I had to say that after.
All right, cool. I'm going to read a dilemma. So everyone, I need your silence. Silence, all right? This lady really needs our help. So we're all going to be a family and give her our assistance, okay?
Yes.
Listen closely. Uh-huh. Now, uh-huh. I don't normally do this, but I really like you boys' answers to dilemmas. So I need your help. I've been engaged for 3 years.
Three years. Calm down. At least you find someone to engage you.
That's not even that long, Seth.
Huh? But I've been with my fiance for 8 years.
He's
very successful. He has a great job.
Add that one to your maths.
He has a great job,
mm-hmm.
a nice house,
Hey.
And a nice car.
A nice car. Wow. See that one.
Lamborghini Urus, to be precise.
You get that one.
That one, yeah.
I've got a decent job, but I look after my mother and my two siblings. So I barely make ends meet.
So basically, she's an encumbrance.
What's that one?
Encumbrance.
A liability. Let's go.
Fake news, fake news. Boo, boo.
They don't do that. Relax yourself.
No. And I look after my two young siblings, so I barely make ends meet. But my man loves me same way. Aww. Very good. Come here. Aww. So sweet. My fiance is quite flashy with his expensive clothes and shoes. Mm. And he saw a lot of my friends have nice things.
So, Carly, I feel like this is you.
Is it me? Hey, guys, how am I looking today, though? Come on, come on. Yeah. I also like nice things.
Except diabetes.
But it's not
sugar.
Me. It's not me. It's not me.
Okay.
Yes. So, what did I say? Yeah. He saw my friends have nice things, bags, cars, clothes, when, for me, I shop in Primark or Boohoo. Oh. Wow. Okay.
Primark. Very modest.
Very modest. So for my 25th birthday, at my birthday dinner, he surprised me with a Louis Vuitton bag.
Wow.
I couldn't believe it. All my girls were happy for me. A few months later, I went with my girl to the Louis Vuitton store to pick up her bag as she had it customized.
Wow.
When we were there, one of the assistants pulled me aside and basically told me my bag was fake.
Oh.
Wow. I was so embarrassed. And when I told my friend, it turns out they all spotted it at my birthday dinner.
Wow.
From the box it came in, but they didn't want to tell me. I'm so angry, I can't believe my fiance would do this. Banang.
Hey.
Why lie to me and buy me something fake and present it as authentic? Why cheapen yourself when it comes to gifting me, but you have no issues spending money on yourself?
Hey.
I didn't even ask for this bag. Now I don't know what to believe. Is his stuff real?
No.
I've called off the engagement because I cannot marry a man that will lie to me, and I cannot start a marriage based off lies.
That's very harsh.
Am I overreacting?
Wow. Okay, no. So,
Uzi, we have
listen,
a conundrum.
Listen, no, guys, let's look at this the right way.
Wow.
Okay.
This guy is a very, number one, she has a lot of good support system around her.
Yes.
Yep.
The fact that they didn't tell her straight away.
They didn't. They kept it quiet.
They were
true.
Considerate of her feelings.
Uh-huh.
So let's start there. Number two, one thing I learned from you, actually.
From me?
Yes.
I don't wear fake shit.
Not that one.
Oh, okay.
In terms of how to stay rich.
Aha. Uh-huh.
You don't stay rich by just splashing your money.
Don't do that.
Come on.
I didn't teach you that one.
Oh, you didn't teach that one. You did. You told me that one.
But
we'll talk about that another day.
Uh-huh.
But my main thing is this, right? Come on. Everything else is going good. The things that really matter.
That's true.
I think...
Is it going good if they've been engaged for 3 years, bro?
Wait.
3 years.
See, guys, people like to look at the bad stuff.
Okay.
You mentioned nice house.
I did.
Nice car.
I did.
He's earning good money.
I did.
One thing I think he did wrong there is I would have told you the bag is fake. So mind who you go around carrying this bag. But everything else... Like, come on, guys. I think it's too harsh.
Uzi. What of you now?
I mean...
Should she call off the engagement?
No, that's too harsh now, like DTM said.
He's very harsh.
Because of that. They can speak about it now. It's not that bad.
What's there to speak about?
I mean... Yeah, that's a bit mad still. Now that I'm thinking about it, it's
Bro,
a bit mad.
I think what... Let me talk up for the girl, yeah? She's saying all her friends knew the bag was fake. At her birthday dinner.
But that's not their problem to tell her that.
Yeah, but that's embarrassing. Why would your man?
But is that my place to tell you?
No, I'm saying that you can't say it's a minor thing, bro. You've embarrassed me.
To who?
To my people.
Maybe he thought he got a good fake. You know, there's levels to fake.
There is no good fake, bro. At the end of the day, yeah. As a man, so would you, if your girl bought you something fake? Would you be cool with that if you found out from other people?
No, I think the difference is this. I'll be pissed off.
Uh-huh.
But I'm not going to break up with her because of that.
Yeah.
We're going to have a word. Like, yo,
Like, Wagwan, I ain't taking nothing from you again unless it's socks and boxes.
Would you want to know if they knew it was fake?
Exactly.
Because some people might not know it's fake.
That's what I'm
saying. That's one thing.
Some people don't know.
He's making a good point. Maybe who sold it to him said he fell off a Louis Vuitton truck.
nah, bro.
And he thought it was real.
He could have gone to a personal shopper.
It happens to the best of us.
Nah, bro. He knew that was fake. If he's the way she's describing him, the way she did it, Money Man, yeah? Money Man knew that bag was fake, bro.
No, so Carly, listen. I feel like this guy is a smart guy. He spends money on things that are very important. Okay, wait. All right, guys, who's got a mic? Because
somebody
I feel like there's people out here that want
to
try to
message
and box me up.
Over there.
Okay, let me go.
Here.
Oh,
over
she's
here,
over
right
there.
Here.
No. Thank you.
Start right here first.
No, just here. She's over there.
There,
with the green
hat. Yes.
Oh, is it her?
You're next.
You have something to say?
You're next. Yeah, let's hear your opinion. You're waving your hands.
I mean, I feel like he knew that she had, like, friends with money. So why would you give her a fake bag if she would know? And her friends would tell her. So
do you think that's enough for her to break
up? Obviously not to break up, but it's already enough to at least to confront the situation.
Yeah, to have a conversation.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right, cool. Okay. All right, cool. Thank you.
We didn't consider that maybe he's been wearing fake designer this whole time as well.
Plot just twist, saying.
Yeah, maybe that's why he became rich. Maybe that's how he became rich.
But wait, can you give him back the mic? Wait. Can you give him back the mic? Okay, how are you dealing with the situation if it's you?
Yeah, imagine that bag there, you're carrying the grey one, he's fake.
Are you breaking up with him?
Yeah.
And the boyfriend gave it to you.
You're breaking up with him?
Yeah.
For the engagement?
Yeah.
You're breaking up?
Yeah.
She said, yeah. Why?
Because he didn't have to go out of his way to buy a fake bag. He could have just got me something simple.
You are very harsh. You're harsh.
I'm with you.
You're too harsh.
You know what you deserve. You do not deserve fake bags.
So because of a bag...
I'm not saying he should buy
these are material things. Wait. In the Bible. What did he say in the Bible?
What?
What is it? I wanted my guys to help me. You guys left me.
All right,
we see what you're doing.
Over there, the green hat.
We have someone there with the green hat, please.
No, with the green hat. The green hat, yeah.
She's just over there. There. Yeah.
The lady are not playing, you know.
People are harsh, yo.
People are very harsh.
Man, them buy real things, though.
Hi, I think that...
I see you over there.
I think that the dilemma is not complete. The dilemma is not complete.
Okay.
So, I think the friends are fake.
Oh!
Yes.
Ooh,
because if my friend, for me, if I see something that's fake, I'll call it out straight away.
Wow.
The friends are fake. But also, I don't think I'll break up the engagement because there's nothing wrong with fake designers.
Oh,
okay.
No, there's nothing wrong with fake designers. She's wearing Primark.
Oh.
If the designer was so fake, she would see it.
Oh.
But it was all right.
Plot twist.
Yes. So, but I would also question why did he present the designer bag as if it was real? That's what she needs.
Birthday dinner.
She didn't say that.
She said it was real.
She said
that, yeah.
At a birthday dinner.
But she said he was
Guys, please, keep it down, please. Thank you.
On the dilemma, did she say, my boyfriend said he gave me a Louis Vuitton bag?
No, she
because it was real.
She said, let me read Banang.
You ha.
She said.
What did she say?
So for my 25th birthday, at my birthday dinner, he surprised me with a Louis Vuitton bag.
But did he say it was real to
no,
her?
No, he didn't say it.
Exactly.
Ooh, I like you. You're a liar.
Exactly.
I like
she
you.
Shouldn't be mad.
I
she
like
shouldn't
you.
Be mad.
Listen,
I'll be
I
mad
want to
at
give her 20 pounds right now.
I'll be mad at their friends, not him.
Okay.
That's what I'll do.
She went off technicality. I love that.
I like that. I like your opinion.
Yeah. I love that. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you. Let's see from the man.
I think we got someone else over there. Look, there's someone else over there.
Hey, Mandem, I want to hear your opinions as well, you know.
I swear now, Mandem are very... No, over there.
Over there.
The LA. New York.
If it works.
She said M.
Hey, Hannah.
M.
To be honest, I don't blame the guy.
Oh.
Reason being is because from the moment he said that the girl's not a designer girl like that, he probably thought, I'm not going to spend over $1,000 on a designer wear with a girl that doesn't even value designer. She still wears Primark and PLT. That's one.
That's one.
Number two.
That
girl, all of her friends are fake less. Fake.
But.
Reason being is because I don't know how your friends can't cover when something is fake on you.
Wow.
I'm so sorry. If I was one of her friends and I had a nice designer bag and I know your bag is fake and it was your birthday, I would kindly put your bag in a boot and I'll say, wear my bag because my bag looks nicer on you.
Said,
I can't allow you to collect embarrassment near me. Wow. Are you okay? Because they will now think I'm fake the same way you are. But that guy, I can't lie, it makes me feel like he's a bit of a counterfeit.
Oh.
Because if he's buying fake designer, what else in your wardrobe is fake?
By the way,
so true. To be sincere, both of them are very stupid. Yay. And their marriage should not continue. Because both of them are fully and foolish.
Wait. Hey. Hand that microphone back. So if this was you,
yes, are you never be me. It can never be me. I cut my cloth according to my size. Thank you.
Yeah.
Never be me.
Come on.
Never. But say if it was my enemy, but not me.
Okay. You are a serious Nigerian woman. I like that.
Thank you.
If it was your enemy, are you breaking off the engagement?
Of course. Yeah. Of course.
Very harsh.
No, let me be realistic.
Thank you.
I will have to have access to your bank accounts.
Oh.
I need to go and verify your designer items.
Wow.
I need to verify everything that's expensive so I know moving forward, there's no such thing as counterfeit. Because imagine now, people will be thinking we're rich outside, but we're fake at home. I reject you.
I like that.
Me not like run them games.
Come on. I love that. Any other opinions?
I am scared.
We need a Mandem's opinion.
Any Mandem, come on, man.
We said.
But Mandem, you might not move in too cool.
Hey, Mandem, don't be shy.
Mandem, come here.
This guy here, the A. This guy's talking a lot.
Yeah, he's talking a lot. Yo, no, you're talking a lot. Yeah, let's hear what you gotta say.
Let's hear what you gotta say. Why are you doing that, though, bro?
Let's hear what you gotta say, my boy.
Bro,
chat to us, my
boy. If this was your boy, what would you advise him, Banang? All right, for me.
No, not your boy, your sister. Your sister. Sister.
And first things first, it's very obvious that she's not really fussed about the designer business.
Yeah.
Okay? That's the standard there. That's the big thing there.
Mm. Yeah.
For me, he shouldn't have bothered to go out there to buy whatever he bought for her, knowing that she wasn't obviously a designer person. Now, if that was me, what I would do is advise my sister to have a conversation with him, okay?
Uh-huh.
To say to him, do you know what? I'm not a designer person. I don't appreciate the fact that you went and bought me something that is fake. It is embarrassing. Please do not do it again. Breaking off the engagement, that is a mad move. Because again, that's a whole engagement. You have a nice home, you have a husband that is, well, a fiance that has a nice job, a well-paid job, you know, a good car. That's more than enough. So a conversation is worth it.
Please, round of applause.
But wait.
Go on.
Charlie, why do you want to be an enemy of progress?
No, because I'm speaking for our sister. Do you know her?
I don't know her, but I'm speaking for her.
Okay.
Why have they been engaged for 3 years but he's buying fake bags?
Good question. Right.
3 years.
Right. Hold on.
How can he answer that?
Hold on. First of all, I'm not in the situation, so I can't really speak on it. However, you can't really speak on people's situation. You don't know what's happening behind closed doors. You don't know the things that she's doing
or
saying, which is making them think twice about the relationship. Ooh. Maybe.
Exactly.
Maybe.
Wait. What say Maybe. You to that to come?
What say you? He's buying fake bags, bro.
What
say you?
What say you to that?
Yeah, he's buying fake this and that. But he's getting paid. He has a nice home. He has a nice car. Come to
maybe
his house.
He's
show you a
doubts,
good life.
Bro.
But listen, that's the thing with society these days. We're too much into, you know, the materialistic things. We're not about the homes, the, you know.
Thank you.
You know, when you go home, you want to feel homey.
This
you want to feel cozy.
This man is a very rich man. I can't
tell. You know what I'm saying?
He's a very rich man. But he's a very rich man.
He's definitely
hey,
taking.
Spray us some money, please.
Dude, don't do that.
No, I hear it. I hear it.
Don't do that, bro.
I hear it. That's a good
but
one.
But seriously, the value is in the homes. You know, how well your family is. Not about the things, you know, that don't matter, like the clothes and, you know, the watches and all that sort of stuff. However, it is nice to have those things, though. I'm not going to lie. It is nice, but live within your means, people.
Come on.
Round of applause.
Come on. Does anyone
want
to challenge
dope,
that?
Dope, dope.
I feel like there was a hand
does
over there.
Does anyone want to challenge that? Oh, look.
There's hands got, over there.
Oh, down there.
Yeah.
There's two hands.
Hey.
Oh.
This thing is really upsetting a lot of people.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We got about.
In my opinion, I feel a situation like that is not merely about the action, but like principle. Like, if this is someone you love, and this is a woman that's an extension of you, you want to make sure she's represented properly. If that's my female brethren or my sister, I'm going to ask her. This ain't merely about the action. So if you can do this with a bag, what's he going to do 5 years down the line, 10 years down the line? And then if you can fake a bag, what else is he faking? And the embarrassment on your head top, that's your husband now. You saw the red flags, you decided to ignore it.
Are you listening?
So off principle, if you can lie about a bag and embarrass you like that, what's he going to do 5 to 10 to 20 years down the line?
Uh-huh.
I'll tell my sister, lock it off,
come
man.
On.
Lock it off. Lock
round
it off.
Of applause.
It's all about principle.
Hey,
it's about principle, not about the action.
He wants
lock
the mic
off.
Back.
Lock it off.
He wants
lock
the
mic
back. We're going to have a battle.
Bro,
he wants the mic back.
You know it's difficult out here.
It's difficult. But you have to ask yourself, do you want to be dancing with the devil now? Do you want to have to question everything he does? Is
the
that
devil
really
you know is better than the angel you don't know.
wait, but you got to ask yourself, is the car his? Is the house his? Do you even know?
That's
now,
true.
Ladies, you don't want to live questioning your man. You want to love your man. You want to trust your man, nah? Nah,
exactly.
Come on. Hey. It's embarrassing. And he knew it, and he did that to her.
Okay, thank you. Give the mic back.
I'm with you, my bro. Down there.
Who else? Sukali, you are just doing rigmarole here.
I agree with the guy who just spoke before me. It would put a huge seed of doubt because, especially because she's a girl who doesn't necessarily want designer things, he could have just bought a nice, cheaper bag.
You know.
Why did you choose to buy a fake designer? And apparently you can afford it, so why did you not buy it, but you can buy it for yourself? It's just many questions. Then it's like, do you even own the house, the car? Yeah, it's just a huge seed of doubt.
So are you ending the engagement?
Yeah, are you ending it?
Say again?
Are you ending the engagement if it was you?
I definitely pause the wedding.
Oh, you
pause it? Pause
you
the wedding.
End it, but you pause it.
That's fair.
Evaluate.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
I like pausing. I like that. We can talk about it, innit?
Yeah, we can talk about it.
Leaning towards no, but
yeah,
pause.
We can talk about it. And I think the girl opposite you, there, yeah.
The only thing I want to add is that this guy may have, like, problems with stinginess.
Oh.
And I think it's, like, on the spiritual side, it could have,
on
like
the spiritual side?
Wow.
He may have the spirit of stinginess. Because the fact that he can buy himself luxurious things, like material, all these things, but doesn't have the thought to buy it for his potential wife, there's something behind it. So there's some sort of, like,
spiritual attack.
Yeah.
Yes.
Not a spiritual attack, but a spiritual stinginess.
We need prayers and fasting.
He's just stingy.
Oh, he's stingy.
And stinginess can break a potential marriage in the future.
I agree with you.
When you have children, when it comes to paying for big things in the family, so it can actually break a marriage.
I agree with you, my sister. We need to pray for this
She's
guy.
She's definitely a member of Redeemed Christian Church
We need
of
to
God.
Pray for
this redeemed.
All right, before we wrap up, is there any other opinions? Okay, we got one more over there.
This thing is causing problem, oh.
This side.
No, we have one more. Just one more and that's it. One more.
Brother, somewhere.
No, she's right there.
There's one there.
Go ahead.
No, we need one more.
Wait. Yeah, we'll do. We've got five
one more.
Right, so I don't know if someone said this already because I can't quite hear, but I would just be like, be honest. Are you broke? Because why am I getting fake Louis Vuitton? You bought me an engagement ring. We've not been married for three years. Come on, I'll question that. Like, that'll be my first question, is why have we been married? And then on top of that, I'll just be like, you're actually just broke. Be honest. Just tell me the truth, because how dare you buy me a fake Louis Vuitton bag?
Do you know what I mean?
Guys.
Do you know what I mean?
You know, you're too money focused, man.
Okay,
we
one more.
One more.
Oh, yeah. There's one there.
No, who's brother Daniel?
Samuel.
We're just going to say one thing each. We just don't understand why he hates her so much. How can you hate your fiance so passionately? I don't get it. He hates her. Just want to question the relationship of being engaged for 3 years. Back aside, 3 years of being engaged is already just red flag. She should have ended it from there. The fake bag is just embarrassing. Yeah, you could collect a degree in 3 years. I'm just collecting fake bags. Uh-huh. Please leave. Please leave.
I'm with you. Listen,
man, we are in trouble,
bro. If you're buying a fake bag, give it in private.
There's one more.
Don't give it in public.
One more. In front of
Brother Samuel.
Brother Samuel.
This is the last one.
Yeah, it's the last one.
Okay, guys.
Samuel just won. How much money?
He just won a lot of money.
Please.
Sweet words.
Yeah, guys, please. I won the game, so I have some sense. Please.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, looking at the variables, we can see a consistency in his spending or finances. So, it would be fair to assume that this is an anomaly out of all of this. So, the assumption that he deliberately bought a fake bag goes against the fact that he has money and he's spending and he is willing to commit and he's willing to buy an engagement ring. This is like, you know, a character profile. Then you have this bag that is supposedly fake. off the friends.
Right,
not verified,
right.
It's fake.
I like that.
Off the friends. Yeah. But then we can also say he was fleeced and he thought he bought a real bag. He's a man with money. He went out, maybe tried to get a rare one, a reseller. Someone came from Paris, said, "Don't worry, I'll pick up one for you.
Exactly.
I'll give you the bread." No, there's so many answers. And all she has to do is talk to him. That's it.
100%.
Fair enough.
Let's protect this man at all costs.
Yes. Somewhere.
One more?
Somewhere. Did you graduate from University of Cambridge?
Look, we'll be here all day.
You're too smart, my boy. One for you.
Hello.
Sukalio.
I think, yeah.
Hello.
I think put the whole man in the bin, period. He's a walking red flag, number one. Also, I think the man has insecurities himself. He's scared that if she's wearing the designer like he does, she's going to go out and find someone better than him.
Wow.
Point number two. Point number three, yeah, is the disrespect for me.
Hey.
To surprise me with a fake designer bag.
Wow.
I mean, first of all, he was not raised correct.
Oh, wow.
He doesn't know how to respect a woman.
Wow.
And he's spiritually not intact, period.
Jesus.
Wow.
You know what, Sukali? No, enough is enough. I think we have a conclusion.
Okay, what do we advise our sister?
Men, guys, if you're out there listening, don't buy fake stuff.
Please.
I'm begging you.
Please.
Don't do it.
Don't do it. What I would advise is, guys, I know we live in a social media age where everybody looks at socials, but you and your home is just you. You lot have to face the ramifications of your actions. Your man's bought you a fake bag. Just say, darling, Bandang, why buy me this fake bag? Why look like a fake bitch to you? Why would you do it? And then he also tell you what happened.
Yeah.
Don't just call off engagements. Women are waiting to be married.
I'm telling you.
I have 7 sisters. Not all of them are engaged, but now.
Talk about it.
You know what I mean? So you're just here praying away engagements. Guys, communicate with your partners, man.
Yep.
Stop following your friends. Following social media. For us, we call it
social media.
Stop following it. Talk to your man.
The last thing to finish off, men. Don't engage for 3 years. If you know you don't have the finances to conclude the marriage, 2 months after engagement, don't do it.
Don't
please.
Do it.
So, hey, have Uzi, the 2 months. Ready.
Have the money ready so once you engage, you follow through with the marriage.
One time.
Thank you, my boys.
One time. Guys, thank you for the dilemma. Thank you for taking
part.
Thank
you very much, guys. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. We're going to give out £100 now.
Sukoni, you have more money to give.
We have more money to give out.
Can I do the honors of picking this out, please?
I hope you
stay back. Stay back. Let me pick it out.
Shake it.
Stay
no,
back.
No. You need to shake it on stage.
Shake it on stage. Give me.
Give it to him. You need to shake it on stage. Uzi, shake it properly.
I'm shaking it. I'm shaking it. Sorry. I have to still pick one.
I told you to cover the
thing. Sorry now. I can still pick one.
No. Leave it.
Sorry.
No, we have to be fair.
Sorry, guys. Apologies.
But
guys,
wait, at least, please. At least you don't know it was properly scrambled.
Apologies, sorry.
Bananga, technical difficulties.
Sorry, apologies.
Yeah, I like this guy.
Forgive us, Uzi, you see what you've done.
£20
fine.
He must top it up with another £20.
Okay, are they all in?
They're all in.
Okay,
let me. Yeah.
He doesn't need to shake it. It's already shaken.
You know like that. Just pick out. All right, guys, we're going to pick out. What are we picking out, Sukali?
One number. Let's go.
So if you've got the number we're picking out, just put your hands up.
Show it to the crowd. By the way, if we pick your number and you come on stage and you're not following us, you're not getting the money. All right.
We're going to check.
What number is
this? This number is a madness, Sue.
Yeah.
It's the same day as Valentine's Day, number 14.
Number 14.
They are going home.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
14. Huh? Come on.
Wait.
Come up.
Is that her? Round of applause.
Come on, round of applause.
14.
If she's not following us, I need you lot to boo her as she's going back.
Check.
So, number 14, come to the stage, please. Come to the stage. DJ, can we play something for number 14 while she's coming? She must also dance.
No, that's wrong, yeah? All right. Shall I pick another number? All right, Sukali, hold this.
Wait, are you number 14?
Yeah.
14.
Yeah. Wow, 14. Come right this way.
Come on stage. Sorry. Hold.
Is that 14? It is 14.
Come.
Wow, number 14.
Give me the money.
Round of applause for number 14.
Wow. What's your name?
Nikita.
Shah Nikita. Are you following? Open your phone, we see.
Open your phone.
Can you open it?
Sukali, give me the money.
We have to count it out loud. So you do one.
Hey, make sure you lick your fingers while you count it.
So people can see it. Is she following us?
We're waiting to verify. Wait.
She's a deserved winner. Uh-huh.
She's qualified.
Open your palm. We give you this money one by one. So we can
count it with us.
No.
Put it in, you need to count on here.
Okay.
By the power minister to me, I present to you this money. Uh-huh.
No, count it.
Count it in our hand.
No, count it onto our hand.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Merry Christmas.
Did you get your money?
Yeah, did I?
Nikita, make sure you don't unfollow us when you walk off this stage by nine. We'll do a refund.
The Holy Spirit is watching.
I'm going to check for 1 month straight. Nikita, come. Take a picture with us now. Oh. Why are you running?
Come.
Don't go anywhere.
Thank you, guys. Round of applause for Nikita.
Well
done,
Nikita.
Now, guys, so first of all, we just want to say thank you so much.
Thank you.
Everyone has supported us. Thank you for coming today to BBE Podcast Agency.
BBE.
Shout out Hoyo Boys.
Shout out YT Podcast.
Shout out YT. Shout out 90s Babies. Listen, we are In My Opinion Podcast. You can follow us on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube. We are funny guys, I promise you. We appreciate all the support. And listen, we out, man.
We're out.
Thank you.
It's the I am
no pod with three young kings. Sukali, DT, and Uzi Bondis. In my opinion, we're the pod of the year. We mix the banter with the edutainment. Sukali, you know, be the girl, them sugar. Don't talk DT, designate driver. Too much Susa. Uzi takes you too far. You never know how far you can go.